Hi guys, C.A. Rachana Ranade here. I was just trying to do a live through my Instagram handle as well. Just give me a minute. Let me see if I can get some good connection on my Insta. I forgot to take my dongle in right now. Chalo, let's see with the 4G connection I'm able to get in here properly or not. Yes, chalo, 4G. Idea of Wii 4G is on, and so am I live on Insta as well. चलो आई एम वेटिंग फॉर 2-3 मिनट्स. उमेश नथानी सेज नमस्कार. नमस्कार से नमस्कार सागर. अमन हेलो. मैनी पीपल ज्वाइनिंग इन. मोर देन 1000 पीपल इंस्टा एंड यूट्यूब पुट टुगेदर. हेलो टू एवरी वन ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. हाय राहुल. हाय वसंत. अमन सिद्धांत नंदीश रवि अक्षय सागर मुलिक से सुपर से भी ऊपर. कैलाश सतीश स्वरूप अक्षय तीर्थ जॉन विजय. वाओ सो मेनी पीपल ज्वाइनिंग इन लाइव एंड सो मेनी पीपल ज्वाइनिंग इन लाइव ऑन इंस्टा एज वेल. आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू शेयर द लाइव स्ट्रीम लिंक विथ योर फ्रेंड्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ लॉट ऑफ स्टॉक्स. ऑलमोस्ट 15 प्लस स्टॉक्स आई हैव टारगेटेड टुडे बिकॉज देर वर अ लॉट ऑफ सुपर चैट स्पेंडिंग इन द प्रीवियस लाइव स्ट्रीम. If you remember last time I had taken a session for only half an hour and then I told that it was my son's exams for which I had to, you know, I had to prepare something for his exam. So that was the reason why many super chats remained unanswered in the previous session. So today we are going to have a lot of discussion about a lot of stocks. So again, I'm requesting everyone to share this live stream link to your WhatsApp status or to your friends, those who are interested in stock market. Let's see if we can hit, right now we are almost 1300 people on YouTube. Let's see if we can cross 3000 people live on YouTube in the next 10 minutes, let's say. almost 700 people on Instagram. But Instagram people, I would suggest that if you want to see Akshay Surve vicharto necklace point kasa hota mi pan janar ahe. So Akshay is definitely following me on Instagram, and that is the reason why he knows that I had been to an area which is known as necklace point. It's a very beautiful place near Pune. It was a drive time of almost 1 hour, and yeah, it was fun. So maybe whenever you find time, you can just hop on to that place and come back. Okay, perfect. Guys on Instagram, I'm going to share my computer screen. So if you want to see whatever I'm showing on my computer screen, then you will have to shift to YouTube. Okay, because I can't show my computer screen on Instagram. So it's your choice. If you just want to hear me listen, if you just want to listen to me, it's okay. You can continue on Instagram. But if you want to learn something very nicely, if you want to see how certain websites can be used very effectively to do analysis, then I think you have to go on YouTube right now. Chalo, so with that, let's move on. Wish, how come you have sent me a super chat of 61 rupees 80 paisa? This is the first time I'm receiving such an amazing super chat. 61 rupees 80 paisa, interesting. Chalo, okay, with that, let's start with certain super chats. What I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly show you I'm going to share my screen with you so that you get to know which stocks am I going to discuss about. So that's a picture in picture for you, and the very fun first one is of Greaves Cotton. Okay, so I'll just quickly search it. Greaves. So Nikhil Saugule had asked this question. He had said that, can I consider buying for midterm Greaves Cotton? He had also talked about the FII holding increasing, whatever. Ester Industries, I've not dealt with so much, but yes, Greaves Cotton, I thought of it's worth mentioning. So what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to quickly give you a snapshot of what Greaves Cotton does. Greaves Cotton is a diversified engineering company. Oh, the Potterhead says, what's the channel name on YouTube? Oh, it's CA Rachana Fadke Ranade. Okay, so even if you type Rachana, then that will be my first search. I don't have a caller, but I can still do that. Okay, chalo. Going back to our discussion, Greaves Cotton Limited is basically an engineering company, a diversified engineering company, and it's a 160-year-old legacy it has. So if the screen is not much visible, I can just I hope now it is much better. I've zoomed in quite a bit. Perfect. Chalo. So with this, here you can see that the revenue from operations is more or less steady. So like from 11-12, it was 1926, and in 1819, it was 1988 rupees in crores. So not a big jump as such. Even if I'm talking about PAT, profit after tax, it was 185 crores in 11-12. And even in 1819, it was 169. I'm not considering 1920 so much obvious for obvious reasons. That because of the COVID scenario, there may be situations where their performance has dropped quite a bit. Okay. Okay. Many people on Instagram, those who are joining in late, they're asking, are you live on YouTube as well? Yes, Instagram people, I'm live on YouTube. You will not be able to see my screen if you are watching me on Instagram. So if you want to see my screen, please switch on to YouTube. My channel name is CA Rachana Phadke Ranade. Okay. So I hope this message is clear. Okay. So I just also wanted to show you one more screener for you. The company name was Greaves Cotton. So here we are with Greaves Cotton. Here if you see the company's financials, here you can see that the ROCE, the return on, I'm again zooming in for your comfort, return on equity is 13.7, not very impressive. Return on capital employed is also 18.2%, again not very impressive. Now if you check its peers, see for peers, here you can see price to equity it is highest. Okay, so a little bit expensive it is as compared to its peers. But if you talk about ROCE, Swaraj Engines is having a much higher return on capital employed. Okay, debt to equity, almost all are very good. Current ratio also nothing special. Pledge shares, no one has, nothing special. Greaves Cotton has 40.37 of free cash flow. That its peers has a much higher free cash flow. If you're talking about P2BV also, it's not very much surprising. Last point which I wanted to tell is about return on equity. It's 13.74 versus Swaraj Engines, which is 29.99. So if I just do a quick comparison of Greaves Cotton versus its peers, obviously amongst all these, I felt that Swaraj Engines is a stock which is it's performing much, much better as compared to Greaves Cotton. As I mentioned, see, PE is also lower as compared to Greaves Cotton. Check out Swaraj versus Greaves. In PE, Swaraj is better. In ROCE, Swaraj is better. If I'm talking about free cash flows, Swaraj is again better. If you're talking about equity to reserves ratio as such, again Swaraj is better. Dividend yield, yes, it has. Here Greaves Cotton zero. And if you're talking about return on equity, it is 29.99 versus 13.74. So given a choice, if I'm considering Greaves Cotton versus Swaraj or versus its peers, I feel in this space Swaraj Engines has much better fundamentals as compared to Greaves Cotton. Okay. So that was it about a quick understanding about Greaves Cotton. One more super chat which was asked was on Ruchi Soya. Ruchi Soya, again, I've just mentioned here very quickly and very cleanly that you should ideally avoid this stock. It's a completely news-based stock. Everyone knows about this stock. Can anyone quickly tell me the name? The moment I'm talking about Ruchi Soya, which company can you relate it to? Chalo, quickly. The moment I'm talking about Ruchi Soya, which company can you relate it to? There is a company. Yes, Siddharth has given the correct answer. Patanjali, Pavan has given the correct answer. Karnati, very good. Bharat has given the correct. So many people have given the correct answer. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So yes, some people are saying Alok as well. It's similar to Alok as far as its volatility is concerned. But if you're talking about the company which I can relate to, that is Patanjali. Okay, so yes, perfect. So again, let me tell you, I'm not a big fan of this company. I would like to give you an advice that you should avoid such stocks, or you may consider these as party fund stocks when you can invest a very small amount and just see how it performs in the medium to longer term. Okay, the next question was on India Bulls Housing. And India Bulls Housing, again, there was a news here that the FIIs and promoters shareholding is decreasing. Now, again, many people ask me, ma'am, where do you get such information from that FIIs and promoters shareholding is decreasing? Is that a good sign or a bad sign? Obviously, it's a bad sign. Promoters decreasing their shares, it's not at all a good sign. FIIs decreasing their holding, again, not a good sign. So if you want to check out how do I research about this? So the name of the company is India Bulls Housing Finance, right? So that's the company. And if you want to check the shareholding pattern, I'm just going down. Yes, check out the shareholding pattern. Here you can see promoter's stake was going down, 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 down till here. Last two quarters, it is improving a little bit. Last two quarters only. Same thing is with FII. FII is going down, 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 down. But for FIIs, it is still going down, down, down. It has not recovered also. So FIIs were holding almost 60%. And now it is holding only 38.66%. So not a very, very positive sign as such, I may say. Even if I'm talking about its main core fundamentals again, ROCE, ROE in again the range of 10.2-13.8. Again, I'm not a big fan of these such companies where I'm getting a return on equity, return on capital employed in the range of 10-15%. Okay, you can definitely get better bets who have a very high ROE as well as ROCE. XX5 says, ma'am, your screen is not visible on Instagram. Maybe you joined in late. I'm again telling you that if you want to see my screen, you have to come to YouTube Live because I can't share my screen on Instagram. Okay. So those who just wanted to hear to me, they can still continue on Instagram, your choice. Right. Okay. So moving on to the next stock, Aeon Exchange. I'll just quickly give you a brief on Aeon Exchange. Their profits have increased from 94 crore to 66 crores. And their revenue has also increased from 1195 to 1515 crores. Okay. EPS has also increased from 57 to 80.55. All in all, the top line, bottom line, EPS, all are increasing. That is definitely a positive sign. So prima facie looks as a good company. Okay. Raymond, right now in the obviously a current pandemic scenario, the stock has seen a big beaten. It has gotten impacted badly. The entire sector as such has gotten impacted badly. So no specific exception for Raymond as such. Okay, so let's see how the festive season comes ahead. Let's see how things pick up in Diwali. These stocks are hoping that a good Diwali, Navratri, Christmas bring them good hopes, right? Okay, chalo. The next question was on Amazon and Reliance deal. I will just quickly tell you what exactly was the super chat. Amazon, and yes, that was of Nikhil. Future retail tussle between Amazon and Reliance deal and your opinion. Okay, perfect. I will tell you about my opinion on Reliance and Amazon. But for that, I would like to focus on the screen again. Understand, if you are following my reels, I hope everyone knows, because like Instagram people know that, I hope Instagram people know that I'm posting reels every single day. YouTube people, I hope you are aware that I do prepare Instagram reels every single day. For those who don't know what are Instagram reels, it's like 15 seconds, a quick shot. Okay. Like YouTube has also started YouTube shorts. Instagram has 15 seconds bites wherein I can put up some good finance related news, some stocks and news is what I post on Instagram every single day. So those who are not following my Instagram account, guys, you can please follow my Instagram account. Pratik, if you are around, please paste my Instagram handle here. It's @CARachnafadke, but I don't have the link with me right now. Or those who are on YouTube right now, if you know my Instagram handle link, you can just paste it here. By the way, a very nice news I would like to share with everyone. Yesterday, my Instagram crossed 1 lakh followers on Instagram. Yay! So thank you to everyone on Instagram and thank you to everyone on YouTube as well. Hopefully you are following me on Instagram as well. So 1 lakh on Instagram is like crazy. Almost 2 to 3 months ago, my Instagram followers were less than 35,000. Okay, 3 months ago, almost. It was 35,000. And then I started to think, what should I do? I started posting reels. I started posting something like a term of the day, then I'm doing news for the day. Sometimes I know I post test your knowledge. So I personally believe YouTube is a platform wherein you can get a detailed knowledge. Yes, thank you, Pratik. Pratik has shared the Instagram link right now. So I'm also repasting it so that just in case if you don't follow me on Instagram, even right now, you can follow me on Instagram. That's where you can get a quick access to 15 seconds knowledge. Okay, Aditya says no Insta advertisement on YouTube. Aditya, ka bara asa kay manje ka tras jala Aditya la, what happened? It's okay. Right, perfect. So well, now moving back to Amazon versus the deal of Reliance, Amazon, Vedanta, the love triangle, what happened, right? So everyone is aware that Reliance Retail and Vedanta, they were about to strike. They have almost, I can say, struck a deal wherein Reliance Retail, I can say just Reliance, okay, Reliance was buying into Vedanta stake. Okay, now the problem was that Amazon said, wait, you can't do that. Now why? Because Amazon had purchased a stake in Vedanta as well as one more group company of Vedanta, and they had a proper contract whereby it said that Amazon has, oh, am I saying Vedanta? Oh, I'm so sorry. Sorry. It was futures. It is future. Sorry. Someone posted about Vedanta right now. I read Vedanta and I started thinking about Vedanta in my mind. Okay, galti ho gayi. Sorry. I wanted to say future. Okay, cool. Right. So let me again repost the love story. It's between Future Group, Reliance and Amazon. Okay. Future Retail. Absolutely. Yes. My team is also pinging me. Ma'am, it's Future Retail. You're talking about Vedanta. I'll also talk about Vedanta. Why not Venkatesh? Because there are so many people who are just popping me out messages. Ma'am, Vedanta, please. So that's where maybe I got confused, right? So now what happened was that Amazon said that we do have a primary right that so something known as a call option. Okay, now what's a call option? Amazon said that we have a right to buy the entire stake also, or a part of the stake also, within 3 to 10 years of the agreement. Okay, so Amazon said that it is our first right to buy into the stake of Future Group. So that's where they have appealed in the Singapore court, and the case is still pending. So it will be an interesting one to see as to what turns this entire case takes up. But it's a very different thing. I've not checked. I've not seen such a case before. So it would be interesting to see what happens in this case. So right now, just to sum up quickly, Reliance and Future were entering into a deal. Amazon said, wait, we have a primary right. It's called as a call option. We have a right to buy the stake in Future within a time frame of 3 to 10 years. Okay, so ours is the first right. So you are whatever you are doing is not correct, is what Amazon has said. They have appealed in the Singapore court. Okay, so that was a super chat which was about Amazon and Reliance. Many people are asking about UTI AMC as well. I guess I have a super chat today as well on UTI AMC, if I'm not mistaken, or someone had put in the normal comment section. Last time also someone had asked me about UTI AMC. I hope everyone knows that what happened to this stock today. The stock listed at a price below its issue price. Did not perform well. It fell by almost, yes, Aman Desai says, fell almost by 13%. If you have seen my video on UTI AMC, I had very clearly mentioned that I don't see the fundamentals to be very nice. So that is the reason why I would not be recommending you UTI AMC. And I felt very nice that I had not recommended this stock. If you remember that in this entire IPO season, I had given no, don't buy, don't subscribe for this IPO on two IPOs. I said don't subscribe for two IPOs. Can anyone tell me in the comment section which two IPOs I said don't subscribe? Because both these IPOs did not perform well. Perfect. Pavan has given the correct answer. Angel and UTI. Akshay also has given a correct answer. Bharat, Karnati, Siva said read. Shubham Devra. Many people. Fantastic. So many people have, it seems you have seen my videos. It's there on YouTube, obviously, today as well. These were the two companies wherein I said I didn't like the financials as much, so I would not buy into these stocks. And see, that is the power of fundamental analysis as well, wherein we can make our own decision as to whether we should buy or we should stay away from such companies, right? Okay, perfect. So if you have gotten the shares of UTIMC, all the best. See if you can get out of this stock at least closer to your price wherein you had bought it. If you see a little bit upside, immediately get out of it. Don't wait into that. Okay. Right. So one more super chat was asked, was about Tata Consumers. Tata Consumers, just for those who don't know, it owns a large market share in the kitchen segment. If you ask me about Tata Salt, if you ask me about Tata Tea, Spices, Pulses, all these are by Tata Consumers. Okay. The only thing is that the stock has already rallied almost 60% since March 31st. So, fundamentally good company, but because it has rallied so much, I'm not saying that directly jump on into it. You can just see the levels and then think and buy the stock if you also feel that it is good enough, right? The next question, the next super chat was about Ambuja Cement. But for Ambuja Cement, again, I would like to share my screen. For some reason, I would show you the reason as well. Ambuja Cements. It's a very interesting thing which I'm going to share on my screen on YouTube. So if you want to check out my screen, just shift to YouTube channel. Okay, this is about Ambuja Cements, right? Again, ROCE, ROE, not amazing as such. They have a good free cash flow. If you check the pros, it's a virtually debt-free company, has been maintaining a very healthy dividend payout ratio. As I mentioned, return on equity is not that good, not that promising as such. Okay, now if you can see the screen, there is something very odd that you can see on the screen right now. Can you tell me what odd can you see in the screen? This is the profit and loss account, okay, and almost 9-10 years data you can see on the screen. Okay, what odd can you see on screen? This is yearly data that I'm talking about. Can anyone tell me? Cash flow, expenses, jump. Nope. Profit jump. Nope. Okay. Siddhant Nayak says that December 15 to December 16 is a big jump. Big jump. Okay. Wait. What is odd? You said December 15 to December 16 is a big jump. Wait. I was showing you yearly figures. What is the year end? Quickly tell me, what is the year end? Yes, Makarand Bhide says December ending. Guys, I hope everyone knows that generally 98-99% of the companies, you will see that all are March ending. Year ended is generally March. But there are very few companies which opt for a financial year ending other than 31st March. And people might not be aware about this fact that this is very much allowed in India. You have to take an approval of Ministry of Corporate Affairs that we want to have a year ending something other than 31st March. Okay. And it seems that they have taken a proper approval for this. And that is the reason why Ambuja Cement has December year ending as its financial year end. Just for your knowledge, I'm sure everyone has heard about Nestle. Yes, Nestle is also a company which has its year end as not March, but a different year end. Anyone knows what is the year end for Nestle? Is it March or is it December or is it something else or what? If people don't know, it's okay. But it is again December only. Okay. So there are a few companies which have a different odd financial year ending. So that's why I thought of taking this point, especially just for your knowledge. Okay. The next one was asked about TCS. What should I say? TCS is definitely a good company, one of my favorites. Very good, fundamentally. You might also be aware that they have announced a buyback of 3,000 rupees per share. And they have also declared a dividend of 12 rupees per share. The stock has already rallied quite a bit. There is a chance that it might rally further again, but not too much immediately. It may rally a little bit from here. To my knowledge, it's already around 2800 levels, 2800 to 2900 levels. So I don't see a big jump from here immediately in the shorter run. Okay. Someone had asked about PI Industries. It's into an agrochemical pesticide sector. chemical company. So the moment it's chemical, specialty chemical, all these companies are into super hit category these days, right? So anyways, so the stock is right now at almost 52 week high at 2160 because it's into chemical and special. So chemical sector right now, it might see a good run up again. But yeah, I don't have any special comments other than this on PI Industries. The second last question was about PNG. PNG has recommended a dividend of 105 per share. And the question was that, ma'am, what is a special dividend? Okay. Special dividend is something which company announces other than its final dividend. Final dividend is generally given at the year end. Okay. So I'm repeating, what is final dividend? Final dividend is generally given at the year end. And anyone knows what is an interim dividend? Actually, the word itself suggests, but what is an interim dividend? Sahil till then says, ma'am, you had suggested Wipro as party fund stock, bought at 256 and right now had good profits. Very good, Sahil. Happy for you. Okay. Chalo. So people are not talking about interim dividend. They are asking me some different questions only. Interim dividend, very good. In between, middle people on Instagram are answering. Okay. So it's a mid-year dividend. It's a dividend which is given in between only. Other than this, if a company wants to declare dividend on some special occasion, let us say company completed 50 years, company completed 100 years, in that they might give a special dividend. So that is known as a special dividend. Okay, generally these are given on certain occasions that, as I mentioned, company has completed 50, 100, 150 years, whatever. Okay. Last question was on Ramco Systems. Ramco is again into it's a software company. I would just like to show this company on another software, Indot Trading View. 1 minute. Ramco Systems. Okay, let me just pull up the full chart. The question was that I bought it and it is at lower circuit. Okay, so I guess she had asked me the question on Thursday itself. You can see here that the stock has seen such a huge rally from this level to it's just upper in the air. And the other day when she had asked me the question, it was on a lower circuit. Next day also it was at a lower circuit, but today the stock has hit an upper circuit again. It's at a resistance right now. The resistance that is there as per the Fibonacci levels, it's at 480. Okay. But believe it or not, this stock has seen a dream rally. In July, this July 2020, that's like 4 months ago, the stock was around, 100 rupees. So people talk about Ruchi Soya, people talk about Alok. Even this company, Ramco Systems, has seen a dream run from 111, 101 to 489 levels, okay? But then people will immediately ask, now is it a good time to enter Ramco or not? So that is the reason why I thought I should also show you the fundamentals of this company, okay? See the ROC, 6.59%. Not at all happy with this. See the ROE, 1.85%. Free cash flows, negative, can't get worse. Okay, so the website also says no pros found, suggest something. Cons are huge. Okay, so I didn't find anything very promising. See, you can see for Ramco Systems, all other are much better peers. Okay, even with a negative free cash flow, reserves very less. If I'm talking about ROC, pretty less. But a PE which is very, very high, I don't think it is worth buying into this stock at all. Okay, but just thought of sharing this data with you as to how certain stocks can go up in spite of having poor fundamentals. Okay, so that was an example of Ramco Systems. Ooh, with that, we are at the end of Thursday Super Chats. Wait. First of all, let me welcome the pro investors and the members to my channel. I say Aryan, Ajit, GL, Sivakumar, AK, Sarve, Sangharsh, सकेत, अर्चना, योगेश, सोविल एंड अतीत, वेलकम टू मेंबरशिप्स. आई होप एवरीवन इज अवेयर दैट ऑल माय यूट्यूब मेंबर्स गेट वन कम्युनिटी टैब एवरी वीक. यू गेट अ गुड नॉलेज बाइट देयर इटसेल्फ. And one stock of the month, this stock of the month we are expecting to be released around 18th of this month, 6 days to go roughly. Guru Nandan also, welcome to memberships. Okay, now I'll try to take super chats for the day. Ma'am, please do a video on demand supply trading strategy. Okay, yes, video suggestion taken. We'll do that whenever time permits. Ma'am, your views on Deepak Nitrates, it looks promising. Deepak Nitrate has again pretty good fundamentals, very nice ROE, very nice ROCE, return on equity, return on capital employed, both are very good. So surely it is a good one, Deepak Nitrate. Shonit says, ma'am, your views on Airtel after today's closing. After today's closing, I didn't check out today's closing for Airtel as such. I don't know what happened. Let me just pull out the chart. Where is the full screen? Yes, there goes the full screen. It is at a good support right now, but it seems to be a little bit in a sideway moment. Have I shared my screen? 1 minute. Okay, I didn't share my screen. So that is a daily chart for you. Okay, all these you can see are the Fibonacci levels. Okay, right now you can see that there is a little bit of MACD crossover, but the RSI is like very less. The stock is in a range bound position right today. It's down by almost 2.39%. So nothing special here. It's in this range. Hopefully this support is not broken. If this support of 410 is also broken, then the next support you can see here is at 376. Okay. So right now there is nothing special in this stock right now. I would have preferred to stay away from this stock. Right, the next question is on views on Tata Motors. Tata Motors and all the automobile company stocks can see. Oh, by the way, I just checked out 3,500 almost on YouTube, almost 400 on Insta. So good, we had a target of 3,000 plus on our stream today. And yes, good, you have all achieved this. People have even started liking the video right away. Everyone thought maybe now I will talk about likes. The moment I talked about viewers, people remembered, array, we have to give more likes to the live stream. Perfect, perfect. Guys, take these likes beyond 1,000. Will be fun. Okay, chalo. Again, moving on to Tata Motors. As I mentioned, all automobile companies, eyes on automobile companies right now for a simple reason. Diwali, Dashera, Christmas, New Year, everything is coming up. All automobile stocks can be definitely checked out into. There are great chances that these companies might post better results in Q3 as well. Okay, view on Bharti Airtel, it is down 18% in few weeks. That I actually answered this right now. Right now it seems to be in a little bit of range bound scenario. Let's see how it performs. Ma'am, your views on Infobeam Tech. I've never tracked Infobeam Tech, but if you want I can quickly show you on screen as well. Infobeam Tech, 17.9 ROC, 15 ROE. I generally don't like these stocks. Arre baap re, and its peers are like Tata Elxsi, Persistent, CMP itna hai, P ROC 17, debt to equity 0.23, not bad. Free cash flow for Infobeans is also -7. No, fundamentals don't look good at all. Okay, so I would not go ahead with this company. Okay, can you do a fundamental analysis on BSE and NSE? Wish, I talked about your super chat. I can do a fundamental analysis on BSE, because for those who are keeping a track on stock markets, I hope everyone knows that BSE is listed, and BSE is listed on NSE. Is BSE listed on BSE, guys? Yes or no? I want an answer. Is BSE listed on BSE? I want answers in yes, no. Says Priti. Sandeep says no. So many. तो अपने ही दुनिया में रहते हैं, वो अपने ही questions पूछते रहते हैं. मैं कुछ भी बोलूँ क्या फर्क पड़ता है? No. Perfect. Very good. One answer, one to aim, and Harshvardhan has given me the answer. Siddhant has given me the answer. Lokesh also. Very good. Chalo. So the correct answer is no. There is a reason why, because it is a law that you can't list your own company on your own stock exchange. Okay. So that is the reason why BSE is not listed on BSE. BSE is listed on NSE. And if NSE wants to get listed, then NSE will get listed on BSE if in the future it does get listed. Okay. Perfect. So I can do a fundamental analysis on BSE, but difficult on NSE, right? Akhilesh Chinna, ma'am, not receive Arti bonus, got 2 days before X. You got it 2 days before the X. You should contact the RTA in that case. RTA is the registrar and transfer agent. First contact your broker, okay? Ask your broker the reason. If broker doesn't give you an appropriate response, check who is the RTA for this company, and RTA will ideally help you out with your bonus, right? Puneet Natani says, ma'am, when is your course on options trading coming? I hope everyone saw my my video on options trading basics. I taught the meaning of options. Many people felt that my camera got damaged that day when I threw the ball at the camera. So it's fun shooting such videos. Yes, there are so many people who are wanting a separate video on a separate lecture series on futures and options. We are working on that before the financial year end, that is March 2021. Surely we'll be coming out with it, but right now we are working on the valuation series. Okay, ma'am, Raymond 1300 to 300 views for long term. As I mentioned, Raymond, right now it's interesting to watch how it will turn out with the festive season. Otherwise, right now it is completely beaten down. So I think it's a wait and watch strategy for Raymond. Don't jump into it right now. Manali Petrochemicals. Never heard about this stock. We'll write it down. 1 minute. So the first one that I'm writing it down is Manali Petrochemicals, because there are so many super chats still unanswered. So if I have not tracked it, I'll just quickly write it down. Okay. Sagar, I hope you are aware that I do a live stream every Monday, every Thursday. So even if you don't get an answer today, it's okay. On Thursday's live stream, we'll get your answer, right? CDSL, any advice on that? It's a good one. Fundamentally, if you're a long-term investor, you can enter into bits and pieces, small quantities. Don't jump in at a single point of time. Please advise for BHEL. Why is it going down? Why is it going down is not what I've studied very closely. Like, if you know, that reminds me. Wait. Why it's going down? I hope you have seen my video on Coal India, wherein I made a very similar theme that Coal India, why it is going down. And there was a terminology which was about coal offtake and coal production. So I did receive one or two responses wherein people said that, Pam, there is a little bit different interpretation for coal offtake and coal production. There is a possibility that I might have misinterpreted that, is what I received an email. If you are, or if you have worked in the coal industry, coal related sector, okay, if you have worked in the coal sector, in the coal industries, then I request you to drop an email at research@rachnaranade.com. I'm repeating, research@rachnaranade.com. Almost 3500 plus people are watching here right now. Again, I'm repeating, if you have worked in the coal sector, any one of you, please drop an email so that even we can have some better discussion on that, as to what is exact, what could be the actual interpretation of offtake and production. Okay, I got an email stating that there might be a little bit of confusion, so just wanted to ask for your help. Okay, so perfect. The next one, I got one more super chat in between that I missed a super chat or what. Ma'am, your views on Airtel. I did talk about views on Airtel. Tata Motors also I talked about. Views on Bharti Airtel, I did talk about. It's down 18% in few weeks. As I said, technically I did tell that it is at a support level right now. We need to see if that's not broken. views on Infobean, Infobean Tech. I showed on Screener. FA on BSc was one thing I forgot to write down. FA on BSc. Right. Aarti Drugs, I answered. Options Trading Course, I answered. Raymond, I answered. Manali Petrochemicals. Again, I'll write that down. Manali Petro. CDSL also I talked about. Ma'am, please advise for bail. I've written down. Your engineering on your take on Bhansali Engineering. Kahan kahan se laate ho yaar stocks? Bhansali Engineering Polymers. Okay, analysis on Balmerori. Yeah, all these stocks and MGL. Okay. Too many stocks asked in one, but I would surely answer about MGL, Mahanagar Gas Limited. It's a very good stock fundamentally. Recently, it has seen some correction, but I feel if you're a longer term investor, MGL is a very good stock. I hope everyone knows that it almost enjoys a monopoly in Bombay and areas around that for supply of natural gas. Okay, so it's definitely a good one if you're thinking from a long term perspective. Shirish Kumar saying, thank you for the super chat, Shirish. Hi, ma'am. I'm also a biggest fan. Thank you. If I had an opportunity to spend a day with you, I might be next Warren Buffett with you as my Benjamin. Ooh, you always treat all your subscribers as family. Please show us your portfolio and holding. Shirish, I'll tell you, I had received many requests that please show what is in your portfolio. But you know, the problem is that I personally feel that everyone's portfolio and the thought which goes behind buying any specific stock can differ from person to person. My risk-taking capacity can be different. Someone else's risk-taking capacity can be different. So for example, if I buy some stock, which I know is a little bit risky, still I buy that stock. I buy it in good quantity because right now I have that much risk-taking capacity. I will set my stop loss. I will get out of it whenever I feel that, yes, my stop loss is being hit. But you know, there might be people who will just blindly follow that because it is in Rachna Ma'am's portfolio, I'm going to buy it, finish. Now, whether that stock suits their risk profile or not is a big question, correct? So that is the only reason why I'm not a big promoter of this thought that I should be showing my portfolio, my holding. But yes, if you are a pro investor, Shirish, whatever stocks go in my stock of the month, for my pro investors, all these stocks are in my portfolio. So let me be very clear on that also. Whatever stock of the month I suggest for my pro investors, that is there in my portfolio. I feel that there is something in that, and that is the only reason why I take it as a stock of the month. But again, same thing. I would never disclose how many quantity because same thing. Just because I have bought 1,000 quantities doesn't mean everyone has to buy 1,000 quantities. There might be many more richer people than me might say, hey, Rachna buys only 1,000 quantities. See, I will buy like 5,000, 10,000 quantities. Okay. So yeah, that is the reason why, Shirish. Sorry, I can't honor your request. But an opportunity to spend a day with you, that is possible. If you come down to Pune, let me know. We can surely meet up. I can show you some nice places in Pune. If you're a foodie, there are nice restaurants like Vaishali, Rupali, Vadeshwar, and all these things, right? Okay, perfect. Prasanna, ma'am, I bought Mazagon Dock. Can I hold or sell? If you have gotten it in the IPO, nice. If you're a long-term investor, Mazagon Dock is a good one. If it's up to your intentions, if you're happy with the listing gains, you can quit as well, okay? Because there are other investment opportunities which are available as well, okay? As Anusha says, hi ma'am, I have 20 IRCTC shares bought at 1365. Is it better to hold or sell? Is there any chance of share value increasing in January? Okay, I'll pull up the chart of IRCTC for you. I have discussed about this stock quite a number of times. IRCTC search. Let me share you my screen as well. Full feature chart. I hope everyone knows that there is a dividend news in IRCTC. Okay, so dividend, I guess it's very less. Less than 10 rupees to whatever I remember. So let's see how it pans out. The problem with IRCTC right now is that it was in a pretty much range bound. It is still in a pretty much range bound zone. It is not going very less also. The lowest ranges we can see is around 1320 levels. So this today the stock has closed at the S1 support, okay, which is 1334. If this is broken, you can see the next support is around 1300. But still, 1300 is a very, very, very good support, I can say. Post this, there's a big fall up to 1250. But I feel that 1300 being broken, I feel there are very less chances, is what I believe. So if you get a chance around 1300, if you've already bought into it, if you are a long-term investor, then I feel that is a good chance to, that could be a good chance to average out your holdings. Of course, try to see that if there is some reversal or not. Okay, if you see that there are certain reversal signs coming up, it would be much better to do an averaging. All right, it's 9:47, guys. I will be stopping the stream in like another 5 to 10 minutes. It's okay even if you don't send super chats right now. Of course, I'm going to come live on Thursday again. Okay, Shrikant says, I have done the mutual fund course and now I'm confident in choosing funds. As you say, own research gives super feel, and please give some giveaway for fundamental. Shrikant, thank you for such an amazing feedback about the mutual fund course. Whatever course I make, I just try to give my 100% for this, that people should get a confidence that they will be able to pick stocks on their own. They should be able to pick up mutual funds on their own. So, if you have not checked out my course, I believe everyone who is on the stream right now, you can definitely check out my course on mutual funds. If you just want to see, if you want to get a feel of it, my first lecture in this entire course, lecture one, is free. So you can at least enroll for the first lecture on mutual funds, which is absolutely free of cost. The website is rachnaranade.com. That's where you can check out all my courses. Okay. So thank you, Shrikant, for the super chat and for such a nice feedback on the mutual fund course. Okay. Raj Gaj, thank you for the super chat. No questions asked. Views on HBL Power, Bajaj Hindustan Sugar. Wait. HBL Power and Bajaj Hindustan Sugar. Okay. Next one is that Sadashiv Rege, Axis Bank stock review. That's a good one. If you are again a medium to long term investor, Axis Bank fundamentally looks good. The only problem, Sadashiv ji, is that the entire banking and NBFC space can be in a mess if there are a lot of NPAs. So if you are getting into this stock for not a very long term perspective, it is okay. In fact, I should say, going for a short to medium term for Axis Bank right now, looking at the scenario of COVID and looking at the scenario of possibility of higher and higher NPAs. Okay, so I would just suggest that even if you're entering, it's fundamentally a good stock, no doubt about that. But please keep a track of the stock movement, see their quarterly results as well, and then stay invested. Okay, that's it about Axis Bank. Pranjal Prasoon, thanks for the super chat. View on Reliance Naval. Have not checked its fundamentals of late. Reliance Naval. Even if I don't remember these figures offhand right now, I'm quickly writing it down because we don't have that much time left with us. Ma'am, please suggest about Airtel and JK Paper also, your stock of the month. Yes, JK Paper is not doing so well right now. If you remember when I had released that stock, one of the major reasons was that people were saying that, ma'am, stock of the month, please give a stock of the month which is low priced and all that. I'll tell you one more thing that happened was JK Paper was one of the industries which the paper industry as a whole again took a very bad hit because of COVID scenario. So JK Paper has been hit pretty badly because of COVID. Fundamentally, it is not a bad stock at all. But yes, if you are not a long-term investor, if you're not thinking from the long-term perspective, it is not performing well, that I know right now. So it depends on what is your time frame of investment, Rajgach. whether you want to really stay invested or not. Airtel, I did talk about just some time ago. Views on Britannia bonus debenture. Suman, if you are holding the equity shares of Britannia, then you're going to get debentures. Okay, these debentures, as the name suggests, these are bonus debentures, so you're going to get it free of cost. Okay, to whatever I remember, it was in the ratio of 1:1. So if you're holding one share, you will get one debenture free of cost. Okay. Aman Agarwal holding 1,000 shares of Ujjivan Small Finance Bank at 40.81. What to do? Again, fundamentally, Ujjivan Small Finance Bank is a good one. Depends on your time frame where you want to whether you really want to hold on to this or not. But if I'm talking about fundamentals, it's a good one. ICICI Lombard and Bajaj Finance. See, the moment we are talking about any NBFC right now, it all depends on how much NPAs these companies are going to have in the coming few months. But otherwise, again, Bajaj Finance is also, it's a very expensive stock, very, very, very expensive stock. But yes, it is fundamentally pretty good. Okay. Good time to invest in PSUs like ONGC, NTPC, NALCO. Yeah, investing in PSUs is not bad at all. You get a very good dividend yield in many companies. So yeah, it's up to you whether you really want to invest or not. ONGC is a good one. NTPC is also not bad. NALCO I've not really tracked off late. So just check out for NALCO, please. Pranjal Prasoon says, ma'am, please, Birla Corp ke bare mein bataye, bahut din se 706 buy price pe fasa hu, current market price 628. Also, please tell your views on Bandhan Bank. Pranjal, I'll take both your queries. Bandhan Bank, I guess I had talked about it in the previous live stream, but if you want me to show the stock on screener as well, then I'll show it in the next live stream. We are really running out of time right now. So Birla Corp, Bandhan Bank, both in the next live stream. Okay. Guys, please stop the super chats. It's almost 10. Views on SBI. SBI, again, fundamentally not bad, but again and again, I'm repeating, banks, NBFCs right now are can be in a mess is what I believe in. I believe in. My mom actually accumulated 8,500 LVB shares over a period of 12 years. And sadly, purchase price is not available. Purchase price is not available. Should she hold or sell? LVB is what? LVB. It doesn't show up. LVB is what? Lakshmi Vilas Bank? Not sure. I'm not sure what is LVB. Dinesh, if you can just give me the full form of LVB. I can't see it on screener or IndoTradingView also. Yeah, Lakshmi Vilas Bank. That's what I said right now. But really, is it listed? I'm not sure. I can't see its price right now. Am I misspelling it? Wait, Lakshmi. No. Can't see it as a listed one right now. I'm not sure whether it got delisted or what. Okay, let me just see if I can get some more information about Lakshmi Vilas Bank. Some issue with bank management. Not sure. PVR share, hold, sell or average. Oops. I would stay away from this share right now, because even if theaters open up, I don't think that they're going to run in full capacity right away. So yeah, I don't think you should be really holding on to PVR share right now. Or it could be like a party fund stock wherein you don't have a lot of quantity, so that you are okay with a little bit risk as well. Rajgach, my third super chat, please reply. JK, I just did reply, Rajgach. Oh my god, I missed it. Arre bapre, so many more super chats, guys. Okay, last 5 minutes, whatever super chats are pending will be done in the next stream, don't worry. But stop super chats, please. Please inform about your opinion about Mothers and Sumi and GTL Hathaway. Mothers and Sumi is a good one. Fundamentally, very nice company. Hathaway, I don't like the fundamentals as much. So if you're a long-term investor, if you are having a choice between Hathaway or Mothers and Sumi, I would definitely go ahead with Mothers and Sumi. Okay. Central Bank, Maharashtra Bank, please, had got for short term and now it is down now. Guru Nandan, I said banks is what right now don't really interest me. So neither Central Bank nor Maharashtra Bank. If you see some recovery in these on a technical basis, maybe you can just average and go ahead with getting out from these stocks. I'd asked about Reliance PP in Thursday's live stream. I did discuss about Reliance PP, Supriya. In fact, I also gave two video links. Just search about Reliance rights issue on my channel. I've properly told about what is Reliance PP in those two videos as well. For those who still don't know, Reliance partly paid is not a fully paid, as the name itself suggests. Some value of almost, I forgot the exact numbers right now, some 316 is paid up right now, another 316 and another 600 something is payable. The first installment would now be due on somewhere around May 2021, second installment around November 2021. Okay. Could you please tell me your views on PVR Indian Hotels, as after Corona, can there be a rally? I just talked about PVR, same logic applies for Indian Hotels. I don't think they will be rallying like immediately, right away. That will be a slow uptick in both these stocks is what I believe. HUL is at 2135 for long term, their fundamental. HUL is a very good company fundamentally. Anytime, I again label these as buy on every dips. Definitely can go for it. Shannon says, hello ma'am, really like your videos, gained a lot of knowledge at the age of 19. Nice. Also, can you give me your views on Chambal fertilizers if possible, ma'am? Chambal fertilizers, will take it for the next one. It's a good stock, I can show on screener. So next time I'll show it on screener. Only 3 minutes left now. Okay, Pradnya, thank you for the super chat. No questions asked. Stock says, ma'am, had asked for fundamentals of Mindtree last time and you had noted it for Q&A. Nahi, I didn't talk about Mindtree. So the next time Mindtree will be the first one. Stock. Mindtree fundamentals. I'll show it on screener as well as in dot trading view as a compensation. Okay, so Mindtree FA plus TA, fundamental analysis plus technical analysis in my next live stream. Promise. Okay. Right. From Rumu, Guram, Paras, Atit, Varun, Bhuvan, Amrit, Prasanna, Prasant, Pradnya, Puneet, Apoorv, Rajgaj. It's my fourth super chat for today, but ma'am, you haven't responded to my chat. By the way, I want to ask you about JK paper. Array, Rajgaj, thank you for your super chat, Rajgaj. I will remember your name for sure, but I did answer your super chat. But thanks a lot again. And thanks a lot again. And really, thanks a lot again. I also said you thank you 4 times. Okay. Ravi Indar and Himanshu, Kilan, Nikhil. Esther Industry. I didn't talk about what? I did talk. I don't remember. Okay. If not, in that, I'm just calling out all those whom I'm going to talk about in the next live stream. Karan, Suraj, Sangeeta, Satish. My God, K. Sachin, K. Bala has just given me a thumbs up. Thanks, K. Bala. Abhijit and Robin. Okay. All these questions, all these people. Thanks a ton for the super chats. All these super chats help the channel to grow better and bigger. So thanks a lot for all these super chats. All these questions I'll be answering in my next live stream. It's 10 and I'm a person who doses off pretty early, so it's 10. I'm an early riser. I wake up on an average at 5:15, 5:30 every day. It's feels very good early morning, but if I have to get up at 5:30, then I have to wake up pretty early. I have to sleep pretty early, and 10:30 right now also my eyes are like pulling me. Chalo, go to bed. My bed is calling me right there. I'm going to doze off now. So Sudhakar says good night, Rachna. Archana says thank you, ma'am. Your sessions are always enlightening. Thank you, Archana. Amrit Pant says 6 a.m. club. Abhi kuch nahi, no views on any of the stock. I just have one view on sleep right now, that I'm going to go to bed immediately. Okay, So thanks a lot, guys, for coming for the live stream. I hope you are liking this stocks in news series. Okay, that's how we get to know more and more about stocks. You also gave me good homeworks. I have to do good research. So that's my research list. 11 research lists plus so many unanswered questions. All these will be taken care of. Don't worry. Sagar asks, ma'am, you should start early morning live sessions. Early morning, Sagar, I prefer to exercise. So no early morning live sessions. Okay. Chalo, so that's it from my side, guys. Jai Hind. Bye-bye. Good night, Insta people. Good night, YouTube.